Founded on April 10, 1948, the Wilmington, Delaware chapter of the Lynx Incorporated has spent 70 years creating service projects designed to enhance the quality of life for residents in the Wilmington community. Today, the Wilmington, Delaware chapter boasts a membership of 60 women who perform transformational programming in five facets: services to youth, the arts, national trends and services, international trends and services, and health and human services. Born in the aftermath of World War II and facing new concerns in human rights, social and racial justice, the organization was of necessity compelled to respond to its national environment. One of the earliest chapter meetings was hosted in the fall of 1948 by Kay Lorraine Hamilton and Elizabeth H. Anderson. At this meeting, the members planned aid to local hospitals, a toy shower, and a party for underprivileged children. The 1950s was a busy decade for the organization, with many of the activities either focusing on civil rights or supporting civil rights organizations. The first documented event was an author's tea featuring renowned scholar J. Saunders Redding and Dr. Ira Jiggett. Redding, a professor at Brown University and Guggenheim scholar, was the brother of Louis L. Redding. Another early activity held in 1951 was an interracial talent show to benefit the United Negro College Fund. The event was held at Howard High School, and performers came from such institutions as Lewis High School, the University of Delaware, Wilmington High School, and Ezean Church. Among the judges was noted drama critic for the journal Every Evening, Ashworth Burslem. The MC for the event was Joe Bostick, the first African-American radio disc jockey in New York City. In these early years, the Wilmington Lynx brought many African-American celebrities to the city. For their first major fashion show to raise money for the NAACP, they presented the well-known Towel Sisters. Lois was a Juilliard-trained concert pianist who performed throughout the U.S. and Europe. And Dorothea was a well-known model who wore creations by Schiaparelli and Dior. This event was the precursor to the Ebony Fashion Fair. Later that year, the Lynx presented a $500 check to the NAACP at the National Conference in West Virginia. This was one of the first major contributions to the NAACP. These donations continued over the years, and eventually the chapter became a life member of the organization. Never afraid to attack tough issues, the chapter in 1956 actively supported the boycott of segregated movie theaters in Dover, Smyrna, and Middletown. On September 16, 1957, the Lynx sponsored Duke Ellington and his orchestra at the Playhouse. It was the first time Ellington had appeared in Delaware, and the event received considerable attention in the press and attracted an audience of approximately 900. In a review, Henry F. Davidson stated, "The Wilmington chapter of the Lynx Incorporated raised the cultural level of the state several notches in bringing the master to the Playhouse. If some other organization wants to match this contribution, perhaps they should try to get the Metropolitan Opera Company." In the year following, the chapter hosted the Eastern Area Conference. One of the highlights of the meeting was a discussion led by Daisy Lampkins, vice president of the Pittsburgh Courier, entitled "The Challenge of Integration." This event was held at the Walnut Street YMCA and was open to the public. The main conference proceedings were held at the Hotel DuPont. Another first during the decade was presenting the Ebony Fashion Fair at the Gold Ballroom in October of 1959. The proceeds benefited the local branch of the NAACP and the United Negro College Fund. The Lynx joined a long list of other organizations in fighting for fair housing. They supported Senate Bill 128, which addressed the issue of racial discrimination in housing. As major civil rights were won, the organization began focusing its attention more broadly on cultural issues. In collaboration with the Delaware Art Museum and the Board of Trustees of the Wilmington Society of the Arts, the Lynx sponsored one of the first major African American art exhibits in the state by featuring the work of six Philadelphia artists in 1972. Music was also important in this decade. The organization sponsored concerts featuring Lynx Jacqueline Falcon and also provided Wilmington Music School scholarships. The chapter even purchased a chair at the newly renovated Grand Opera House. Also during the 1970s, Lynx Yvonne Jensen became the first Wilmington Lynx to serve as regional officer and chair of the arts for the Eastern region. Again, focusing on equal rights, in the 1970s, the chapter turned its attention to the plight of migrant workers in Delaware. They successfully lobbied for better housing, pay, and working conditions. The chapter even adopted a family for about 2 years, providing clothing and smaller necessities like toilet articles for the adults and children. The chapter focused its attention on intercultural issues with the International Perspectives and Cultural Contrast Conference held in 1984. This event brought together speakers from the University of Delaware and the organization People to People, along with international students from local colleges and universities. In 1985, the Lynx were featured in the local newspaper for their outstanding work. In that article, President Catherine Azor stated the focus of the organization was drug abuse among African American professionals. During 1987, the group also addressed teen pregnancy. Nationally, in the 1980s, there was a great deal of attention on the plight of the black male, with special focus on the African American male child. During that same period, in 1987, the chapter, realizing that little honor was being given to local young African American males, decided to jointly sponsor a program with the Wilmington chapter of Kappa Alpha Psi fraternity to ameliorate the situation. This collaboration resulted in the creation of the Achievers Program. This vital program was designed to develop and encourage excellence in young African American men, while also seeking to create positive images of these males in the total community. The culminating event, the Affair of Honor, is an elegant formal banquet and ceremony, at which time the young men are presented to their community and receive scholarships and other awards as a result of their participation in the program. The program received an award from the NAACP for exemplary service to the community. For over the past 30 years, this program has engaged 750 African American young men in the city of Wilmington and provided $750,000 in scholarships. Approximately 95% of the young men in the Achievers Program enter college. The chapter returned to the Delaware Art Museum in 1992 to present the art of Jacob Lawrence. On opening night, the organization sponsored a reception with the artist and his wife, Gwendolyn. In 1994, the chapter collaborated with the Christina Cultural Arts Center to sponsor an exhibit of Romare Bearden's work, Joy of Living. This traveling exhibit included a painting from the collection of LINC member Dr. Janice Tilden Burton. In conjunction with the exhibit, jazz artist Shirley Scott provided a workshop and performance. The exhibit earned the chapter the second place award in the arts at the LINC's 1995 Eastern Area Conference. Later in 1996, Nancy Wilson and Joe Williams were presented in concert at the Grand Opera House. Health also became an important issue for the LINC in the 1990s as the chapter organized walkathons, which encouraged healthy activity and also served as a fundraiser to aid the homeless, the hungry, and others in need. In 2010, the chapter co-sponsored an exhibit on Haitian art at the Delaware Art Museum. The chapter felt an urgency to reverse the disturbing trend of underperformance in math affecting Delaware's youth. As a result, from 2010 to 2017, the Wilmington chapter of the LINC Incorporated ran the award-winning and highly successful STEM Education and High School Readiness Program at Servium Girls Academy. This program addressed high school readiness, mathematics competency, and health and wellness. A highlight of the program was the Mathematics Sprints competition, a creative way to debunk the commonly held belief among girls that math is hard. When Nordstrom's at the Christiana Mall opened its doors in 2011, the store held a fundraiser benefiting several organizations, including the Wilmington chapter of the LINC. The LINC used these funds for its work on the Achievers Program, Servium Academy, and It's All About Me. With Delaware Grand Families, the chapter partnered with the Wilmington Senior Center to provide workshops and cultural experiences for children and the grandparents who were raising them. This multi-generational program impacted boys and girls aged 5 to 18. In addition to workshops, the families were served home-cooked meals prepared by the members of the chapter. The program ran from 2014 to 2017. In December 2017, the Wilmington chapter of the LINC launched a partnership with Girls, Inc., to provide additional support in programming and mentoring to help girls grow into healthy, educated, and independent young women. For 70 years, the Wilmington chapter of the LINC Incorporated has made tremendous contributions to the city of Wilmington and the state of Delaware in the areas of civil rights, youth, the arts, international affairs, and health. They have been a true asset to their community.